A very fresh morning to one and all present here. Myself Zainab Kagdi from Atmiya Green School, Jhadeshwar, Bharuch. We are back with English subject for class 5. Today we'll take the explanation of the PDF of the lesson My Life. Unit 9. Excerpt from A Autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. So I'll request you to open up your textbook, that is your course book of Oxford New Pathways, and we'll understand each questions carefully. Take out page number 127 of your course book. Reading 1. Question number 1 says, what was the good news? Who brought the news? Now, what was the good news? As we remember about the mathematics teacher of Abdul who arrived, which was the beginning of the lesson. So the answer to it, if you read out the lesson from the beginning, in the first paragraph itself, the answer exists. The answer to first one is, the good news brought by young Abdul's mathematics teacher was that Abdul had scored full marks in mathematics and science, and that he had also done well in English and Tamil. So dear students, as we know that his mathematics teacher had arrived at Abdul's place to share the good news with Abdul and his parents. So what was the good news, my dear student? It was that Abdul had scored full marks in maths and science, and he had also done well in English and Tamil. Moving up to question number 2, why was the narrator pleased? The narrator was pleased because his teacher had taken the trouble to come all the way to his house to share the good news. As we have discussed in the lesson that if the teacher wanted, he would have waited one day and on the next day he would have shared the news in front of the class with Abdul. But no. He took that much pain to personally meet Abdul and his family and share this good news and tell them that how proud they are because of Abdul. So now your narrator, that means APJ Abdul Kalam, was very much pleased because his teacher had taken the trouble to come all the way to his house to share the good news. Question number 3 says, why did young Abdul have to wake up early? Answer to it is, young Abdul had to wake up early to attend Arabic tuition classes as well as to learn to read the Quran. Correct? So he had two commitments before going to school. First is, he went to attend Arabic tuitions to learn the Quran, and then he used to go to his mathematics teacher place to understand the sums and to do extra practice in maths. Okay, moving up to question number 4. What did young Abdul and his friend Ramnatha Shastri do one day? What did he do? Answer to it is, young Abdul and his friend Ramnatha Shastri built boats made of leaves. So, wo log leaves ki boat banate the. And then, when it rained, they set sail their whole fleet of boats in puddles. Whenever Abdul found an ant or an insect, he would put it in the boat so that it could ride to safety. So here they used to make boats out of leaves, and when it rained, if they found any ant or any insect, they would place them into the boat so that they would have a safe ride during the monsoon season. Question number 4 was, who was Siv Subramania Iyer? What did he do to inspire the boys? Now, Siv Subramania Iyer was Abdul's teacher in the 5th standard. By combining the theoretical learning with real life examples, he inspired the boys to think practically about what they were learning. So we know that when this science teacher used to teach them about the flight of the birds, so when Abdul and the rest of the class questioned him that they didn't understood the concept very nicely. So along with theoretical learning, what did he do in the next day? He planned a surprise for them and he took them to the seashore. So now he combined the theoretical learning with the real life examples, and this way he inspired the boys to think practically about what they were learning. By looking at the birds and their flight and their movement, they understood the concept nicely. Now question number 6 says, how did the narrator feel when he had to leave his town to go for his higher studies to Ramanathapuram? The narrator was sad to leave Rameshwaram. He was scared to leave a place where he knew everybody and everyone knew him, and where he knew every tree and corner. Leaving his family and especially his mother made him very sad. So now, how did he felt? He felt very sad. Why? Because he had to leave his house. Usko uska ghar chhodna pada, aur he had to leave his comfort zone. जो कंफर्ट जोन में ही वॉज लिविंग, ही हैड टू लीव दैट एंड ही हैड टू मूव अराइव टू अ डिफरेंट सिटी एंड ही हैड टू मीट डिफरेंट पीपल. सो ऑल बिकॉज ही वॉज लीविंग हिज फैमिली, स्पेशली हिज मदर, सो दैट मेड हिम वेरी सैड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 सेज, व्हाट वर द वर्ड्स ऑन द प्लग इन द न्यू स्कूल? हाउ डिड द वर्ड्स हेल्प द नरेटर? द वर्ड्स ऑन द प्लग रेड, let not thy winged days be spent in vain. When once gone, no gold can buy them back. The words filled young Abdul not only with hope and expectations, but also helped him overcome his homesickness. Now, what is homesickness? That he was missing his home very much and he was unable to understand what was going on in his life, and he used to miss his home so much. That is called homesickness. So when he read these words on plaque, that let not thy winged days be spent in vain, that means let not this passing days be spent in vain, as these days are flying away. Winged days means when once gone, no gold can buy them back. These days, it will fly away so fast that not even gold, as it is a very precious metal, but now even gold cannot buy them back. So you need to not waste any single day in vain, that is uselessly. It should not be used in vain, it should not be spent in vain. So you should utilize each day carefully in our life. So these words filled young Abdul not only with hope and expectations, because he was missing his home and he was wasting his days. So this helped him to overcome his homesickness. Okay, moving on to reading 2 on page number 127. When talking about the mathematics teacher from class 4, the narrator says, "Oh, school, our school was small, but it had many such teachers like him." What does the narrator mean by the words "teachers like him"? Describe the qualities of such a teacher. So, while talking about the mathematics teacher of class 4, the narrator said that हमारी स्कूल भले ही छोटी है, but we have many such teachers like him. So what does he mean by these words? Teachers like young Abdul's mathematics teacher were caring, patient, kind, dedicated and empathetic. As we all know that he was caring, the teachers were caring, patient. He patient, why? Because they understood what they are learning and then they are finding the solution to their queries. That is why they are patient. They are kind as they are coming to their place, caring for them and sharing the good news, dedicated and empathetic. Abdul's teacher came all the way to his house to share the good news that Abdul had done very well in his exams. This showed how kind and caring he was. He felt the same joy in Abdul's achievements as Abdul and his family did. So describe the qualities. These are the qualities that Abdul's teacher had. And he had many such teachers like him in his small school. Question number 2 says, among other achievements, Dr. Abdul Kalam grew up to become a highly respected scientist and great teacher. He picked up many of his character traits from when he was a young boy. Read the extract from his autobiography carefully. List and describe at least 2 character traits that you see in young Abdul that helped him reach such impressive heights. Now, we all know that Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is a very highly respected, was a very highly respected scientist and a great teacher. So, वो बचपन से ही he had learned, he had developed such qualities. So, we need to find out कि how did he achieve these impressive heights, least 2 characteristics. उनमें वैसी कौन सी 2 खूबियाँ थी, 2 character traits थे जिसकी वजह से he had achieved this much impressive heights. Let us read out the answer. Dr. Kalam was dedicated and hardworking from a young age. He would start his day early to learn Arabic and the Quran. He was also eager to learn something we can see in his willingness to leave everything he knew and loved behind in Rameswaram in his search for knowledge at Ramnathpuram. So here, as we know that he was very dedicated and hardworking from a young age. Why he was hardworking? Because he woke up early in the morning, and before going to school he had 2 arrangements to go to Arabic class and to attend the mathematics teacher classes. And he woke up very early, he read Quran. So he was very eager to learn something, we can say, in his willingness to leave everything he knew and loved behind in Rameswaram in his search for knowledge at Ramnathpuram. So he left the Rameswaram and he went to Ramnathpuram. Why? Because he wanted to learn something new. So if he would have sat in his comfort zone, he would not have achieved this much height in future. So that is all for your reading too. Now we'll move up to the vocabulary section on page number 128. It has phrasal verbs. So what are phrasal verbs? When a verb and a preposition or an adverb act together as a verb, they make a phrasal verb. I repeat, when a verb and a preposition or an adverb act together as a verb, they make a phrasal verb. So for example, lit up, that means showed happiness and excitement. So these words togetherly make a phrasal verb. What does they mean? So we are having some exercise here. Complete the sentence by using the correct forms of the phrasal verbs given in the box. So the answer to it is, number 1st has been done for you. Let us put on our coats. It is very cold. So put on is the answer. It's already given in the textbook. Question 2 says, the thief dashed with all the money. He made off with all the money. The thief made off. Third one is, the 2 friends quarreled this morning. Now they have dashed with each other. Means made up. Means unki dosti ho gayi hai. Now they have made up with each other. Number 4, please dash the music. I want to study. Please turn down the music, I want to study. The answer is turn down. It is given in the bracket. Question number 5 is, Gandhiji dashed in Porbandar and Rajkot, grew up, matlab bade hue. 6th, Lata dashed her pets well, looks after. Lata looks after her pets well. Looks after means uski dekhrekh karna. 7th, please dash the fan. These papers are flying. Please turn off the fan. These papers are flying. Number 8. The firefighters quickly dashed the fire. Put out. The firefighters quickly put out the fire. So now we'll move up to the grammar section on page number 129 and 130. So for this we have adverbs of frequency. Okay. So now what is the meaning of adverb of frequency? So now words like always and never are called adverbs of frequency. These adverbs tell us about how often something happens. कितनी बार वो चीज़ हो रही है, हाउ ऑफन, दैट इज कॉल्ड फ्रिक्वेंसी. ओके, सो नाउ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द क्वेश्चन इज ऑन पेज नंबर 130. पुट द एडवर्ब्स इन द करेक्ट places, one has been done for you. Before doing this, let us understand what do we use, what are the adverbs of frequency and which are they. Number one is, what are the adverbs of frequency? So the words like always, usually, frequently, often, sometimes, rarely, hardly ever, never, these all are the adverbs of frequency. So when in question, when it is asked, find out the adverbs of frequency, you have to identify these words, always, usually, frequently, okay? Now I'll teach you how they are being used. Okay, now always, always means 100%, when the happening of some event is 100% sure, okay, then we have to use always. For example, young Abdul was always eager to learn more. So he was always, aisa kabhi nahi hua that he was not eager. So when it is 100%, when the situation is happen, the happening of something is 100% sure, then we use always. Now we have 60% or 90%, मतलब कि 90 to 60% होता है, तो we use the word usually, frequently and often. That means Abdul often scored high on his mathematics test. Often means 90 to 60% time, not 100% every time नहीं, लेकिन majorly he used to score good in maths test. Okay, now sometimes we use for when there is a possibility of some event for 50%, okay, 50% happening chances hote hai, tab we use sometimes. It means sometimes his mother made sweets to celebrate his achievements. So kabhi nahi hua ki jab bhi kuch achieve kiya hai, she made sweets only, okay. Jab 50%, there was sometimes she made sweets, okay. Now when there are chances to 20%, we use rarely. Means Abdul had rarely traveled out of Rameswaram in his childhood. Rarely means the possibility of something to happen is 20%. Okay, now for 10%, we used hardly ever. He hardly ever forgot the words on his school entrance. Matlab ki wo jo plaque pe likha tha, wo usne hardly ever he forgot. Means there are 10% chances that he might have forgot. Now never means 0%, मतलब कभी नहीं किया. The boys never took food to school, कभी वो लोग school में नहीं ले गए. 0% chances, we use the word never. Okay, now we'll solve the exercise. It's on page number 130. The question says, put the adverbs in the correct places, one has been done for you. Okay, the sun rises in the east. Okay, it is always, we use always when there are 100% chances of something to happen. The sun always rises in the east. Question 2 is, it is wet and cold in hills in the east. So often, you have to use the word often in the sentence on the correct place. Okay, so the answer is, it is often wet and cold in hills in the east. When there are chances to 90 to 60%, we use the word often. Third is, chimpanzees are very clever. Usually, chimpanzees are usually very clever. Number 4, cranes and storks stand on one leg. So cranes and storks often stand on one leg. Generally wo log do hi paon pe khade rehte, but often there are 60 to 90% chances that they stand on one leg. Number E, tigers attack people rarely. So tigers rarely attack people. Rarely means there are 20% chances ke tigers logo pe hamla karte hain. Now question number 2 is, look at the sentences below, write a new true sentence using any of these adverbs. So you're having these adverbs, that means usually, often, always, never, seldom, hardly ever and sometimes. These are the adverbs of frequency. You have to use correct one in the sentences, okay? So now question number 2 is, first has been done for you. Second is, we lock our house when we go out. We always lock our house when we go out. Always means chances are 100%. ठीक है, हम लोग 100% एवरी टाइम वी लॉक आर हाउस वेन वी गो आउट, कोई भी घर खुला छोड़ के नहीं जाता. सो वी यूज ऑलवेज वेन देर आर पॉसिबिलिटीज ऑफ समथिंग टू हैपन, द चांसेज इज 100% वी यूज द वर्ड ऑलवेज. ओके, सी इज चिलीज आर स्वीट, सो चिलीज आर नॉट स्वीट, करेक्ट. सो वी राइट चिलीज आर नेवर स्वीट, 0% चांसेस के चिलीज कोई स्वीट होती है, मीठी होती है. डी इज इट ऑलवेज रेन्स इन मॉनसून, सॉरी इट रेन्स इन मॉनसून, तो ऑलवेज मॉनसून में ही बारिश होती है. सो आंसर इज इट ऑलवेज रेन्स इन मॉनसून. आई ड्रिंक हॉट चॉकलेट, आई ऑफन ड्रिंक हॉट चॉकलेट, मैं कभी कभी हॉट चॉकलेट पीता हूँ, दैट मीन्स चांसेस 60-90%. एफ माई ग्रैंड मदर फॉरगेट्स नेम, माई ग्रैंड मदर ऑफन फॉरगेट्स नेम, दैट्स नॉट 100% एवरी टाइम शी फॉरगेट्स, बट मेजरली शी forgets names, okay, because of old age. G, my friend adds tomato sauce to her meal, so my friend sometimes adds tomato sauce to her meal. H, I have been to Tibet, I have never been to Tibet, मैं कभी नहीं गई Tibet. I come to school by bus, I seldom come to school by bus. J, Sumit comes to school on time, Sumit always comes to school on time. So these were the adverbs of frequency. Moving on to punctuation on page number 131. We will understand what are commas. Today in our class we will understand what are commas and how to use it. Okay, so we all know what are commas. Now why do we use and when do we use commas? Okay, commas have several uses in English. Okay, the first use is to separate words or group of words in a list. For example, if we have a certain variety in each category, we use commas. For example, I like banana, chiku, mango and lychees. So here we have a variety of fruit, that is categories fruit, and we have some more variety in fruits, at that time we use commas. For example, I like banana, comma, chiku, comma, papaya and chilies, sorry, and lily and lychees. Okay, so when we have variety of same category, we use commas. To separate words also we use commas. For example, Unni bought a bag of potatoes, comma, a packet of sugar, comma, a dozen apples and some grapes. तो यहाँ पर जब लिस्ट आती है तब, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेपरेट द वर्ड्स वी यूज कॉमाज. नंबर टू, वेल एड्रेसिंग समबडी, कैन आई हेल्प यू, कॉमा, मैम. सो वेन वी वॉन्ट टू एड्रेस समबडी वी यूज कॉमाज. इन डायरेक्ट स्पीच टू इंट्रोड्यूस द एग्जैक्ट वर्ड्स ऑफ द स्पीकर, हीरा सेड टू विनी, कॉमा, टेल मी अ स्टोरी. सो योर to introduce the exact words of the speaker, when we start what the exact words are, before that we put comma. Okay, after exclamatory words like well, comma, yes, no, why, hello, hey, ye sab ke baad hum comma lagate hain. To include extra information in a sentence, in these instances the sentence will have the same meaning even if the words set apart by commas are left out. Jaise ki the champak tree on which many birds nested was older than all the other trees. So जब हमें extra information देनी होती है कोई भी subject के बारे में तब we use commas. Okay, now we'll do the activity on page number 131. My mother has a herb garden in which she grows curry leaves, comma, mint, comma, coriander and tulsi. So we used commas to separate the words, correct? We must pack 3 dresses, comma, 4 pairs of socks, comma, some woolen and shoes. So here we have a list of something, group of words, we used commas. So pack 3 dresses, comma, 4 pairs of socks, comma, some woolen and shoes. Okay. Third, no, I can't remember where I kept the keys. So after no, we put comma, means that is exclamatory mark, correct? After exclamatory words we use comma. So no comma. Number four, hi, can you tell me where the library is? So after hi, that is exclamatory word, we put comma. Fifth one, why, it is the same man I saw at the market yesterday. So after this is an exclamatory sentence. So why after why we put comma. Correct. Now moving on to writing skill on page number 131. We are having one passage here and you have to note make. You have to learn note making. Here we are having some paragraph and in that we have to shortlist its what is there in the paragraph. Okay. तो जो जो इम्पॉर्टेंट होते हैं पैराग्राफ में वो हमें शॉर्टलिस्ट करने हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड नोट मेकिंग. सो वन हैज़ बीन डन फॉर यू एंड वन इज गिवन एज एन होमवर्क. सो द आंसर टू इट इज डिस्प्लेड ऑन योर स्क्रीन. मूविंग ऑन टू स्पीकिंग, एनकरेज स्टूडेंट्स टू फॉर्मुलेट देयर ओन क्वेश्चन. सैम्पल क्वेश्चन आर गिवन योर. ओके. बींग पोलाइट. सो योर इन ब्रैकेट यू हैव बीन गिवन फ्यू वर्ड, यू हैव टू यूज इट on the correct places. Correct. Give me a pencil. So we'll write, could you lend me a pencil. So these are polite words. How will you kisi se pencil leni hoti, what word will you use to make the sentence polite, to be sound polite. Question 2 is, help me find my lunch box. In bracket it is given, will you please. So we'll begin with, will you please help me find my lunch box. Question 3, what you do think, we'll begin it, what do you think this is. Number 4, when does the bus leave, could you please tell me when this bus leaves. Okay. You should not be doing that, should you be, we'll begin with, should you be doing that, question mark. Okay, so this is your exercise of course book of class 5. I hope you'll complete your notebook with beautiful handwriting.